Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's look at two sample aldol reactions. To start, on the far left is our model reaction. The aldol reaction normally starts with a ketone. It is deprotonated with LDA to make an enolate at the alpha carbon. The enolate then attacks an aldehyde, that's step 2, to make a tetrahedral intermediate. The final step, step 3, is addition of water to make the alcohol in our final product, which is a beta-hydroxyketone. All right, let's now look at our sample reactions. On the top of the screen, we have the starting material and reagents for an aldol reaction. We just need to provide the structure of the product, which we know will be a beta-hydroxyketone. If we look at our model on the left, we can say that our R group is phenyl, pH. Our prime group is methyl from our aldehyde. If we draw this product, then we're finished. That's it. This is our beta-hydroxyketone. Alpha, beta. How about the second reaction? We're given the reagents and the product and need to determine the structure of the starter material. This looks harder. I don't know what it is about rings in molecules. But sometimes students kind of freak out when they see rings. Relax, it is just a ring. Keep calm and chemistry on. We know that the starter material must be a ketone. We also know that the aldol reaction formed the carbon-carbon bond between our alpha and beta carbons. This bond, I'm making it really dark. If we break that bond in our mind, the carbonyl piece should essentially be our ketone. Actually, it is our ketone. That is our starting material. Our starting material contained the ring, so we didn't even need to worry about how the ring was formed. This video is just a simple method for working aldol reaction problems. Just keep in mind that you'll have a ketone enolate reacting with an aldehyde to form your beta-hydroxyketone product.